Did you know that Box has an MCP server? I'm Alex Novotny, Senior Developer Advocate here at Box. Let's check out just how easy it is to set up. So if you aren't familiar, MCP servers allow LLMs, clients, and yourself to connect to third-party systems without having to create as much code. It abstracts an API layer, allowing for a more seamless connection, kind of like charging your phone with a USB-C connector. To get started, let's check out the MCP Server Box GitHub repo over in our Box community space. The first thing I'm going to do is clone the code to my local machine. Once it's cloned to my local machine, I'll open it in an IDE. Our MCP server provides you quite a few tools to be able to access content and information stored in Box. And the beginning of the README goes over all of those different tools, like who I am, asking different questions to Box AI, extracting data with Box AI, listing content, searching, uploading and downloading files, as well as doing something with one of our new products called Box DocGen, generating documents. So if I scroll to the bottom, I will find the information that I need. We've already cloned the GitHub repo over to our local machine. If you haven't installed UV, you'll need to do that first. And then I need to create a virtual environment. So let's go ahead and do that. Then we need to activate it. Once it's activated, we need to lock the dependencies. We also need to create an ENV file. And in this file, we can simply just copy paste over a client ID and secret environment variable. This client ID and secret goes along with a custom application in Box. I'm not going to go over setting up one of those applications. I'm just going to go grab the information from the developer console. If you need more help with that, check out our developer documentation at developer.box.com. And again, here is an application that I've already created. I'm going to scroll down and copy paste this client ID and secret over to the ENV file. Now, to run the MCP server, all you need to do is run this one simple line command. So I'll go ahead and copy paste it into the terminal window. It'll install the packages and it is running now. So now that it's running, we should be able to configure Cursor to point to the server and then run commands that prompt it to use this server and the tools within it. I am using Cursor, like I said earlier. You could also use Cloud Desktop. You could use Client. You could use Windsurf. Any other, you know, MCP client out there that has access to call an MCP server, you could use. And in Cursor, to do this part, you go to the settings window, and then there is an MCP server section, and you can add a new server, and you just copy paste in that MCP server Box section. And I need to correctly format this. I can save this. And then if I close this window, I see that my MCP server Box is in fact here. It actually shows you all those different tools that were in the README. It shows them as individual tools that you can then utilize with this server. So let's try running a command. First, we're just going to say, hey, who am I in Box? And it immediately pulls up calling the who am I tool. So let's run this. Now, I don't have a connection created yet. See, it's telling me I'm not currently authenticated with Box, so I can't retrieve your user information. You'll need to authorize first. So let's say, yes, I want to authenticate. It's going to run an authorize tool. Pop open a window in Box asking me to grant access. I'll grant access and it'll say successful. And if I go back over, now it will run the who am I tool again, and it will say I am logged in as developer relations. So that's really cool, right? So I've downloaded the code. I've set up an environment variable with an application that I had set up in Box previously, and it gave me access to call Box, authorize with that OAuth 2 connection, and then allows me to say what user am I logged in with. Let's go a little bit deeper now and say, hey, what are the lists of files in my root folder? And again, it's going to list, it's going to use this tool called box list folder content by folder ID, which is in this case zero. We can even look at what it's sending and what it's returning. And again, it lists all that information that's within my root folder and box. Let's try uploading a file. And for the folder ID, I'm going to use a specific one. Actually, why don't we just ask the MCP server what folder ID? What folder ID is the folder MCP server? Cool. So it even returned an ID. So let's say that I want to upload the file at this path to folder ID. I copied over this specific invoice into the folder. Let's copy the path. And again, it's going to call the upload file from path tool. We'll run it. Over in box, let's go make sure that it uploaded. So here's the MCP server folder. And look there, we have the file uploaded. And it's the exact same file that I had on my local machine. The Box MCP server has a ton of functionality. It's very easy to set up. You can do things like uploading and downloading files, searching through your content, making Box AI calls, as well as generating documents.